when you say Scarborough, you think about boats and fishing and things like that. You don't often think about aviation. Sure, you might sometimes see a rescue helicopter in the sky, or you might see a private plane, or even a jet plane flying at high altitude towards North America. But one man born in Scarborough had such an impact on aviation design that the Wright brothers themselves credited him with the concepts they used to come up with the very first powered, controllable flight. But who were they talking about? For that, we need to go up there. It was here in 1773 that George Cayley was born. Part of the aristocracy, his mother realised that he was really into maths and science, and so made sure that that was included on his education. And he really, really developed a love and interest in flying. In fact, he became known eventually as the father of aeronautics, although this was likely a title given to him well after he died. And as you can see behind me, there's a blue plaque commemorating him. The question is, why? What did he do that was so important? For that, we need to travel about 8 miles inland to a village called Brompton. As you can see from the sign behind me, Brompton claims to be the birthplace of aviation. Can that be true? You'd be forgiven for thinking it was the Wright brothers who came up with the world's first flight in America. And in a sense, you're correct. But they came up with the world's first powered flight. Before we got there, lots of other things had to happen in the aviation world to get to powered flight. And it was in this very village that George Cayley came up with the main concepts needed for flight. 99 years before the Wright brothers came up with their first powered flight, Sir George Cayley successfully had the first manned glided flight. And it was from a workshop down here, an octagonal workshop, as you can see here, that George Cayley did most of his research, and it was in the fields around Brompton that he tested his designs. At the time, the lack of an engine that was light enough for George Cayley to put his principles into action is really the reason that cost him becoming the first person to achieve a powered flight. He couldn't realistically achieve the propulsion needed at the time. So that's why he was limited to glided flight. But it doesn't take away from the fact that what he was working on was years and years ahead of anyone else in the world. Cayley was responsible for making huge leaps with aerodynamics and stability. And it was these principles of aerodynamics and stability that could lead people to eventually create powered flight. In 1804, George Cayley recorded the first successful glided flight in a field really close to here. 5 years later, in 1809, Cayley was forced to publish his plans early because he thought that someone in Vienna had successfully achieved flight before him. In reality, it had been a misunderstanding, and Jacob Degen, the man in Vienna, had actually used hydrogen for lift, so in a sense he created an airship. With Cayley hastily publishing his paper, it had actually ushered in the age of aeronautics. And despite being at the forefront of this technology, Cayley was already well aware of the potential of his invention. He said, "I feel perfectly confident that we shall be able to transport ourselves and families and their goods more securely by air than by water, and with a velocity of from 20 to 100 miles an hour." Cayley's work culminated in 1853 when he successfully launched his Cayley glider in the fields of Brompton Vale with his coachman on board to achieve the world's very first glided flight. I find it incredible that in this sleepy North Yorkshire village, close to where I have spent most of my life, where I've grown up, that the birth of aviation did genuinely happen around here thanks to Sir George Cayley. It's even more incredible that it took a further half a century for anyone — the Wright brothers were the ones who did it — but for anyone to build on Cayley's work and successfully achieve powered, controlled flight. Cayley was ahead of his time. yes, he was an eccentric, but he spent his life dedicated to flight. He was obsessed by it. He had the principles that he needed, but it took 51 years later than his glided flight for there to be powered control flight in a field in America. Sadly, Cayley died in 1857 and never got to see controlled powered flight. Who knows how long it would have taken to get to that point if it hadn't have been for George Cayley's work in this village in North Yorkshire.